fellas, listen up. Let's listen up. I don't understand your attitude. I really don't. Okay, things haven't exactly been easy for us recently. Hey, I know that. But let's remember one thing. We are a team. I love you guys. Let's all work together. Let's give it 100%. Tonight's match could well be our breakthrough. Come on, gang, what do you say?
Go fuck yourself.
What's happened to you? Where's your sense of humor?
We lost it 3 weeks ago.
Meaning?
That's the last time we got paid.
Our last promoter was mugged. You know that. That's hardly my fault or his, the poor guy's.
He wasn't mugged, man. He was a goddamn crook. He conned you.
Jack MacGyver is going to be here tonight with the money plus our take for the match.
He better be.
Let's try to calm down. Let's have a good workout.
You wouldn't know a good workout if it came up and bit you on your ass. We need a real coach, not some jerk off with big plans and empty pockets.
All right, that's the spirit. Let's go. Come on, that's what I want to see. Get out there. What do you think?
Spirit.
A little less smoking, a little more skating, Diesel. Very attractive habit. Come on, that's right. Come on now, Pee Wee. Good hustle. Good hustle.
This your team?
Yeah, I took them over 6 weeks ago. Pretty good, huh?
It's a rough-looking bunch. Where are they playing?
Right here. They're playing right here.
No. Not tonight or any other night, buddy. We're closed. This place gets the records ball tomorrow. I came to kick you out, man.
Hey, Jack MacGyver said that...
MacGyver?
That crook...
No, you've been had, buddy. Now go on, beat him.
Hey, good work, Pee-wee. That's what I want to see, Ojo. All right. Good attitude. Okay. All right, girls.
Get out of here.
Keep it up. That's the work.
Hey, that's it. Stop.
Who's that?
Stop. Y'all have to get out of here.
What'd you say?
Vacate the premises, and it's time to leave. It's time for y'all to go someplace else.
Where is he? Ragoloff! Come! We're gonna kill you, mother! Son of a bitch!
Lift him up!
Morning, Miss Latimer.
You're late.
He had engine trouble.
Not acceptable.
Sorry to hear your daughter's missing.
Missing, hell, kidnapped.
Really?
What do you mean, really?
Well, would you mind giving me a few details?
Can't. I've got a board meeting. Get it from the FBI. They were here on time.
What does he mean he doesn't know how much money was in that safe? No one gets this rich without knowing where every nickel is.
Police Chief Norris, Deputy Police Chief Dunaway.
Ormond, FBI. What do you know, Chief?
Oh, nothing much. How about yourself?
I mean about the case.
Huh?
Let me fill you in, Chief. Sometime between 11 o'clock last night and 7 o'clock this morning, Randall Latimer's only child, 28-year-old Georgiana Latimer, disappeared from this house, along with an unspecified amount of money. Presumably a quite large amount, judging by the size of that safe.
Turn a corner!
Wait, come on. I am the district sales representative for Glideaway Skates. This is a door-to-door demonstration. We're trying to dramatize the beneficial of... Oh, my God. You're pointing a gun at me. Don't shoot. Okay, the truth. There are five women on roller skates after me, and if they catch me, they're going to kill me.
Five women after you.
I swear to God.
Too crazy to be alive. Five? You must be good.
Could we possibly continue this conversation inside?
Where are you?
You read my mind.
Anyway, Mr. Latimer says that she was kidnapped. Whoever heard of a kidnapper taking the ransom first? This is what bothers me.
Yeah, me too. Dunaway, did you hear any of this? You take some notes for Pete's sake.
I only live a couple minutes from here. Do you mind if I go home now and...
Take your time, Chief. We'll be right here.
Good deal.
Come on!
Don't believe me. Ask my husband.
Your husband? What's he do?
He's the chief of police.
Oh.
Don't worry. He never comes home till dark.
Is this?
The plumber's. The plumber's son. The drain was stopped up in the tub and he skated over to fix it.
Do you expect me to believe that?
There you go, ma'am. I don't think you're gonna have any more problems with that drain. But if you do, don't hesitate to call me or my dad. We'd be happy to come right over. Now, Chief. You look like you've had a rough day. Now, I don't want you to think that frontal nudity, seeming proximity, constitute evidence of a conjugation...
Bend over.
Sorry?
Turn around and bend over.
Fine. That's fine.
Now, one false move out of you, and you get a 38 enema. That's fine, too.
Yeah, that's real good work, Feeney. Over now.
You look like you're having fun.
Well, finally got a make on you, Rangeloff.
Al, I've never been arrested before.
No, but you once lived with a guy who's got a mile-long track record with Bunko.
Who?
Robert Sturdivant, alias Bob Sturdy, alias Robbie Stewart, alias Stu Robinson, Robin Sontag, Sonny Taggart. How about Century Milestone?
Century?
You heard me.
Oh, I don't know him.
Yeah, I bet. Okay, put your clothes back on, you geek.
Al.
Hey, I know my rights. You can't do that.
Now, you listen. After what you done, I can do anything and you don't say diddly squat. Keep your nose clean, Century.
Give me that.
Ooh. Oh. Hey. You all right? Come here. Come here. Let me see what this is. Come on.
Gee. I don't think it's gonna be fatal. You better stop crying. Hey, miss, would you take a picture of us, please?
Take a picture. How's that? Huh? Okay, let's go.
Next time you reach for anything, I'm gonna pistol whip you. Now get dressed.
Look, look at that!
Look out!
Sorry. No, let's stop.
Run away! Stop!
Chief, where the hell that guy come from?
Hey, you! Get out of my way! Come on!
Great. That's all we need. Get hit by a police car. What is all this coughing crap anyway? Why don't we just put the money in a suitcase and go TWA?
By now, your picture's everywhere. Widows with veils are not asked a lot of questions.
Stop worrying. By the time we get on the train, we're home free.
I get for this in a 39 regular.
Hey, well, kick some little flags down here, will you?
Yeah, we're gonna get... Where are we forming up?
That's where the hell the New York City, sir. So.
Tell us where to go.
Senior, give me the flags, will you?
All right, what? You just
get inside. There you go. Oh.
Isn't the hat too small?
So you'll get a haircut. Well, deal.
Oh, that depends.
On what?
On how much cash you're willing to give me on top of the clothes.
Who said cash? Clothes you said, clothes you got.
Hey, that's an expensive watch.
So take off the clothes and put on the watch. See how many restaurants you get into.
Hey, come on.
Take it or leave it.
I'll take it.
By the way, he just didn't disappear. He's gotta be. He's around here somewhere. I know. Hey, can't you make this thing go faster? Faster!
Like to buy a book today? It's all about George Harrison.
I don't like the Beatles.
Where the hell are they? They can't have a parade without flags.
Really, such.
Watch it.
Sorry.
I'll go see if I can find that flag detail.
I'll pay points for. Come on, we don't got all day. I don't believe it the way you live. I don't believe you, man.
How do you? Care for a little flutter there, Sarge?
No. Carry on.
Jesus!
Look out! MPs!
Sergeant. Is that flag yours?
Yeah.
stump run.
Stop. Stop. There's $5 in it for you if you stop.
Yes, sir.
I'm moving.
There's a soldier out on platform 3 beside a coffin with a flag on. Now, if you take this to him and come back here, I'll give you a couple of bucks for a bottle of Muscatel.
All right, I got you in a plane arena. I'll meet you there.
Why?
I got to stay with the money.
So do I.
No, I'm going to take care of Soldier Boy. It might get a little messy.
He can't go to the airport. There were more cops there than here.
What airport? It's an empty lot in Sausalito. The pilot owes me a favor. Come on.
Hurry up there, boys.
Where did the window to the chauffeur go?
Oh, never mind.
Whoa. Here.
What's this?
From the lady in black. No reply requested. Board!
Hello, sir.
The old presidents better than I do the new ones. Garfield, McKinley, Roosevelt, the Rough Rider, not the crippled fella. Now, I'm not much after 1933, but you try me before that and I'm dead on. There was Taft, McKinley, Herbert Hoover, Hoosier, whatever it was.
Mr. Stapleton, would you mind if I just...
What I do remember is when the Amrail took over the railroads. Now, what they tried to do was give me the boot. I was over 65, but that's when I wrote the president.
Of the railroad?
Of the United States. The president of the railroad is dead. Oh. But before he'd passed on, he promised me that I could stay on until I dropped. And so I says, Mr. Nickerson.
Nixon? Nixon.
Nixon, that's his name, Nixon, yeah. Well, I says to him, a promise is a promise. And what was he gonna do about it? Well, when I got his letter of commendation, there wasn't anybody dared fire me.
Nixon gave you a letter of commendation?
Had to.
Why?
Because I sent a Xerox copy of my letter to Walter Cronkite. Now, that war you was in, that was in China?
Close enough.
Who won?
Nobody.
That buddy of yours in the box there, what was his name?
Biddlecoff, Corporal Lane Biddlecoff.
And where does he live?
High River, Nebraska.
We don't stop there.
Well, that's too bad. That's all right. I'll just go to the next stop beyond High River, and then I'll go back.
Well, the tag on the coffin says New York City.
That's close enough.
Well, I hate to see you. Uh-oh, coming into Reno. I hate to ask you, but would you excuse me?
Yeah.
I got work to do. You're going the wrong way for the dining car. I'll show you the way. But don't ask me to make reservations for you. It's first come, first served.
Shit.
Your attention, please. Now arriving on track 7, the Amrail Streamliner, City of San Diego, from Oakland. Passengers will...
Naturally, I asked him what he was doing in my tub. And he said he was the plumber's son.
And you believed him?
Of course not. He was undressed.
And he forced you to get undressed?
Oh, no. No, that was just an unfounded rumor that was being circulated by my ex-deputy.
No, it is. God lives us
here. The Adams destroyed the city of San Gabriel.
Where the hell you been?
Ask your pilot. He had to land twice to get directions. Thought you were getting rid of him.
I am. Right now.
Oh, damn, these boots sure are hurting.
Well, now you ain't used to wearing them things now, are you?
I'll say it once. You get on that train, you're dead.
What?
You heard me, punk. Dead.
Vice President Spiro T. Agnew took the offensive yesterday against reports that he took kickbacks from government contractors, angrily denouncing such charges as damned lies.
What's he doing?
He's probably calling his mother to tell he's catching a later train.
Manya? Manya, it's Michael. Yeah, fine. Is Sentry there? Where is he? No, Manya, no, Manya. Don't give me the number. I'm going to tell you where I am. Manya, if you'll just shut up and listen, I'll tell you.
What?
As a counter move to the Senate Watergate hearings, H.R. Haldeman, White House Chief of Staff earlier this year, proposed leaking a story to the press.
You sure scared him off.
George McGovern was the father of an illegitimate child.
Son of a bitch. FBI.
How do you know?
His shoes. You can't get on here now. It's too risky.
What about you?
I'm Nat Latimer's daughter. I'll meet you in Ogden.
How do I get there?
I told the pilot to hang around in Reno just in case.
I did? Oh, that's just great.
Don't worry about a thing, baby. By the time you get to Ogden, the money will be in the bag and Soldier Boy will be in a coffin.
Thanks for the lift, Chief.
I hope my informants here in Reno were a help.
Yeah, well, if they're telling us straight, my suspects could be on this train.
Well, good luck.
Yeah.
I'm a cripple, right? Like I didn't get it this far by myself, right?
Well, hi.
Sergeant Studd to the rescue.
Hey, look, I just wanted to get...
I know, you just wanted to show me your muscles. Look up in the sky. It's a bird, it's a plane, it's super fag. Goddamn fags.
Forget it.
No, go ahead. Help me. It's about time for some bastard to ruin my life. Why shouldn't it be you? Oh. Sit. I'm a masochist. Well, if you're not a fag, why was that guy holding your arm outside?
What guy?
Him.
I don't even know him.
Why is he staring at us, then?
Everyone is staring at us.
You want to stare? You want to stare at me? You want to stare at me? I'll give you something to stare at. Ta-da! People. You're looking for your cigarettes, right? You won't find any, of course, so then you'll try to bum one for me. What kind of a retard do you think I am? Think you can treat me like shit and then... Mooch a cigarette?
I don't smoke.
I have an idea. Let's calm down. Let's try to have a nice, normal conversation. It's gonna be a long train ride.
So who asked you to take a train? If I'm so fucking boring, why don't you get off and catch a plane?
Because my buddy's lying in a baggage car.
Your buddy? Woo. He's a faggot too, right? What's he doing in the baggage car, waiting for the conductor to punch his ticket?
He's lying in a casket. Cambodia, landmine. I'm bringing him home.
You prick. What did you do? Walk all over the train to try and find me? Now I feel like a piece of shit. You did it on purpose. Just like Rory used to do. That bastard could make me feel guilty for breathing.
Look, I'm sorry,
no,
really.
No. I probably deserved it. I know my faults. Rory reminded me of him for 2 years. So why did I marry him, right? Because I'm an actress, and actresses are supposed to stay vulnerable, right?
Well, Rory's an actor, too.
Male model. That should have told me. That and Paco Rabanne.
Who's he?
It. Paco Rabanne is a cologne. He had a gallon of it. A gallon. Dead giveaway. That and the open mesh jockey shorts.
What's your name?
Don't laugh. Standish Logan.
I like it.
Oh, bullshit. But it's a good name professionally. It's arresting, right?
You act on stage or movies?
Strictly the boob tube. I did a mod squad last year. You probably didn't see it. You were probably overseas. Nobody saw it. The fucking playoffs. My agent said he saw it, but he's full of shit, too. Hollywood. Playground for fags and vibrator salesmen. What's your name?
Michael Rangeloff.
I like the first name. The second one. Are you hungry? Neither am I. I know. Some women gorge themselves when they get divorced. I couldn't. Every time I thought about what he did, I threw up. Listen, could you take me to the baggage car to see your friend?
There's not much to see. It's just a sealed casket with a flag over it.
I'd like to see it.
Why?
If I knew why, I'd probably change my mind. Please?
Okay.
Tickets! Ah, I see. Tickets? This here's for a roommate. You don't belong here. Yeah, I'll show you where it is. Here.
Standish, please don't cry. Look, I got something to say.
Son of a bitch.
Me?
You had to be telling the truth, right? He's hero, right?
Standish.
All the way to the baggage car, I was hoping you were lying, that there wasn't any coffin.
Listen.
You're a hero too, right?
No.
Oh, Jesus, no. Michael.
Oh, no.
I'm sorry. I've just never known anybody like you. All the guys I know are jerks. Like Rory and my lousy manager.
Oh, come on.
You try to take 15% of my unemployment.
Come here.
Hollywood's ruining my life.
Oh,
I'm sorry.
Okay.
Sorry.
It's all right.
Took over the railroads. They was trying to boot me out.
Are you going to punch that ticket or not?
So I knew it was then. There's time to write the president. So I said, we're talking history here.
You okay now? Hey, come on. Wait.
Yeah, I'm fine.
Sure.
Listen, I'm sorry if I got your flag all wet. If it's ruined, you can just send me the bill.
Where to?
The Alan Schnedeker Memorial Recuperation Hospital in Denver. That's where I'm going, to have my breakdown.
You're gonna have a breakdown?
Having. I'm in the middle of a nervous breakdown. Hadn't you noticed?
No. Listen,
I'm gonna regret this the rest of my life.
Listen, punk, I thought I told you to stay the hell off this train.
Hey, who the hell are you?
Shut up, I'm talking. If that cargo's been touched, it's your ass.
His ass? What did you say about his ass?
Button it, bimbo. I'm not talking to you.
Who are you calling a bimbo?
Yeah, who are you calling a bimbo? Get out of here.
You're mine. You're mine.
If he's anybody's, he's mine. Now go cruise the men's room.
Yeah.
What were you gonna tell me?
Forget it, bimbo.
So it says to him, President Nixon, I says...
Nixon.
Nixon, that's his name.
Well, Mr. Stapleton.
Who's that?
You. I'm gonna go talk to the rest of the people on this train.
I'll go with you.
Good.
Get up. Come with me.
Where are we going?
My roommate. Both of you. Up.
Oh, fuck off, faggot.
This won't wait.
You degenerate.
There he is.
What else can happen?
Get your feet off that seat. Ah, lovely to see you again.
I had to ask. I've got it. I'm in Shangri-La, and this is the High Lama.
What's your name, soldier?
Kirk. Frederick J. Kirk.
Thought you said his name was Rangeloff.
Bilikoff. Lane Bilikoff.
That's your name?
No, my buddy's name.
His dead buddy. His buddy in the box.
Who's writing this dialogue, Kafka?
I think Mr. Stapleton's confused.
You got out in Oakland, right?
You're asking a lot of questions.
I got a license for it. Ormond, FBI. Know this woman?
No.
How can you tell? You're not even looking at the photo.
Well, if you can call spending 30 minutes with her, knowing her, then I guess I know her.
Where'd you spend 30 minutes with her?
In her bathtub.
In her what?
In her bathtub. Whose bathtub?
Did you ever work for her father?
Her father? I thought he was her husband.
Who was?
The chief of police.
Latimer's the chief of police?
Who's Latimer? I don't know her.
You're sure?
Of course I'm sure.
What's your destination, Sergeant?
New York.
Who's Kafka?
Maybe it's her first name. I don't know.
Kafka, a first name?
Who are you?
Standish.
No, I'm Standish. Who are you? You told me your name's Michael Rangeloff, but you just told Dick Tracy it's something else.
All right, look, you sure you want to get involved?
Involved? Where have you been?
All right.
Let's go to the club car. You'll buy me a drink. I'll tell you everything.
Including the bathtub?
Even in the bathtub.
So your name is Rangeloff. And you lived in an orphanage until you were 16?
Except for a couple of foster homes for a few months, but I always came back.
Why?
I'm allergic to child abuse.
And then finally you were adopted by this men's sanctuary?
Not adopted. He was raised in the orphanage, too. He used to come and visit me there.
A distinguished alumnus.
Yeah, that's the word for century. Distinguished.
What does he do?
He is a con man.
A crook?
No. When a crook robs you, you know it. There are people walking around today who were taken by century and don't know it.
Thank God you weren't adopted by him.
Well, he did manage to teach me a few things. For instance, I'm going to knock this coin through the bar using this glass. When I got out of the orphanage, I looked him up. I lived with him for a while. He tried to train me, but I didn't have the talent for it.
So, what do you do?
Well, you name it. This week, I manage a roller derby team. Last week, I unloaded cargo from foreign vessels. Cargo! He said cargo!
Where are you going?
Baggage car. Be right back.
Here's the plan. We don't have much time. See, I get off in Ogden, so we gotta get it on before I get off. Get it?
The Sherman tank approach.
You got it.
May I ask you a personal question?
The personaler, the better.
Do you have the clap?
No.
I do.
It's her.
Stapleton, can I get a little closer to that sink, please? Thank you.
Now, I know I was already born when they shot Lincoln. Was it McKinley? Might have been McKinley.
I know where Georgina Latimer is.
Where?
In the coffin. He killed her.
Corporal Biddlecoff's in the coffin.
How do you know he is?
Well, I should think it was me.
Who killed her?
Michael Rangeloff.
Who's he?
The pervert I've been sitting with. Who else?
You mean Sergeant Kirk?
Who knows what his real name is?
Garfield! That was his name. President Garfield. I was alive when they shot him.
I've got it. First, he stole the uniform from Corporal Biddlecoff, and then he ditched him, and then he put her in the coffin, or else they're both in there. Oh my God. Do something!
Why is this train slowing down?
Huh? Oh, we're coming into Ogden.
He'll get away!
No, he won't, because you're not going to let him.
Me.
Yeah. You're going to return to your seat and behave normally.
Normally? I'm in the middle of a nervous breakdown.
You can do it.
I can shit.
All right. Now, in case he tries to bolt, I'll cover the train station. Out on the platform. Okay, let's go.
That girl's got a nasty mouth.
Here
she is.
Have a flower for your bereavement. Okay, don't.
I have been looking all over for you. Where have you been?
In the men's room.
Stop kidding around. I have something important to tell you.
I don't want to hear it.
I think I'm in trouble.
You think you're in trouble?
What is wrong with you?
What's wrong with me?
Will you stop repeating everything I say and just listen to me? Now listen, I went into the baggage
car. No, I don't want to hear it.
I opened up the coffin. Okay.
Oh, God, don't touch me! Oh, my God.
Georgie, over here. Get out of here. FBI on board. Meet me at Grand Central in New York.
What's going on? What about the soldier?
Today.
Listen, you bastard. I want to know
FBI.
What's going
on. Get out.
Oh, jeez.
Eastbound Streamliner to New York by way of Chicago. Train leaving on track 26.
What have I done? Michael?
What is it?
You're going to be so mad at me.
What did you do, Standish?
Well, he didn't try to get off.
Who?
Sergeant Kirk. Let's go.
Right.
Board!
Well, let's go talk to him.
Right. Who?
You did what?
I told the FBI that you murdered Georgiana Latimer and put her body in the coffin in the baggage car.
Give me a pencil.
What happened? What did you do to her?
She'll be all right in a minute. These fits never last too long.
Fits?
She can still hear you. Easy, ma'am. Easy, easy.
What'd you say your name was?
Sergeant Frederick J. Kirk, Special Graves Detail 104.
You can't lay there, miss. If you want to stretch out, you're going to have to rent a roomette.
But she told me that...
What did she tell you? She was Jackie Onassis, Faye Dunaway. The girl's not responsible. Take it easy, Mrs. Biddlecoff. Easy.
Mrs. Biddlecoff? I mean, she's the wife, the widow of... She never said anything to me about that.
You don't mean to say that you discussed him with her?
I'm not sure.
You're not sure? Well, because you're not sure. She's lying here on the floor with her third pencil in 5 minutes.
I had no idea. What can I do?
You can get the hell out of here and leave me alone with her. Do you read me?
Well, if you're gonna lay there, I'll get you a pillow.
Don't get up. Don't get up. Don't get up until they're out of here. Okay. Okay.
What is all this lame Biddlecoff stuff? There's nobody's body in that coffin.
That's right.
Or is there? I know you didn't murder Georgiana Latimer, but maybe you murdered somebody else.
When did you decide to clear me of the Latimer murder?
When I saw her out the window.
Oh, boy.
I did see her, Michael. Oh, Michael, I want to believe you.
Why don't you believe me?
Here's your pillow. He says he wants to see you.
Who does?
In the baggage car.
Who?
Don't press me. The Reverend.
Oh.
Yeah.
Take a nap.
I know exactly what you're talking about. That doesn't mean I'm trying to take it from you.
Don't waste your breath.
Okay, pal. No, just, oh, come on. Come on. Take it easy. Just don't shoot me, okay? Whatever you do, just don't shoot me.
Just gonna have to beat it out of you.
Oh, God.
Now, where's Sentry? You're gonna tell me where he is. You're gonna tell me now. I wanna know where he is. Now, I wanna know. You're gonna tell me. You're gonna tell me real quick. Like right now, I wanna know where he is. And you let me know, or I'm gonna start getting real tough.
I didn't tell him nothing.
It's okay, John.
Keep your nose clean.
Sentry, tell Stanish about the time that you put in the fix at the races at Ohio. Tell her.
Kid, we just burnt the old nostalgia down to the ground. I have a new business. What's up?
You're not a priest, are you?
Not bloody likely. But at the moment, I have need of a high column to the rather unsightly wound heals on my neck.
Where'd you get that?
Bolivia. A word of advice, children. Never try to cross 11 hunter colonels.
Far fucking out.
Precisely. Now, kid, from the beginning.
Slowly.
Well, I had this roller skating team. They were pretty good.
Gently down the stream. Merrily, 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 merrily.
I knew that soldier boy was on the up and up. Tried to tell that G-man, but oh, no, he knows everything. Too bad that coffin has got to go all the way to New York before it gets to Nebraska. Wish I could do something to help. But Bart, let me think. Got it.
So who is in the coffin?
It's a good question.
How would I know? I didn't open it to find out. I see. Well, that's quite a story. Mind if I sleep on it?
Sorry, you didn't get your man.
I'm just getting off the train, Stapleton. Not the case. Like the guy says, it ain't over till the fat lady sings.
Which fat lady's that? You're gonna have to box up them pooches if you're gonna put them aboard.
Fucking agencies. These ain't pooches, they're guard dogs.
Oh, yes, Pilkingtons. Well, where's your shipment?
Out there in the armored truck, but I want to check out this baggage car first.
Oh, yeah, you go right ahead. I'll be right with you. Hello there, Skippy.
Don't tear your arm off.
I'm scared of dogs. I've had all kinds of dogs. Labrador repeaters, I've had English settlers. None of them took a bite out of my ass.
Standish, my dear. Good luck. From the way you guys have been looking at each other, I have a feeling I'm going to see you again.
Bye.
What do you got in here?
My life. It may be a long breakdown.
You're not getting off here, are you, soldier?
No, sir, Mr. Stapleton. I'm just taking Miss Biddlecoff to get a taxi.
That's good, because I got to go call the president.
Oh.
Who's he going to call?
President.
Oh.
I'll just call us a...
Taxi!
Well, maybe you should call one.
Stay.
Is goodbye. I just can't say it.
Yeah, yeah. 5 minutes out of here and you'll be hitting on someone else.
Wrong. It'll be at least an hour. It's a joke.
I know. I know. You really like me.
Yeah.
You ready?
Look, Nimrod, turn on your meter and shut off your mouth.
Now, you have the number, and that's Washington, D.C., person to person. The name, well, I don't rightly recall. He's the President of the United States. That's right, that's right. Thank you very much. Hello, Miss Rosewood? Is the president in? This is Vern Stapleton. Yes, that's right, the oldest railroad conductor in the world. Yeah, I thought they'd get to you. would you just put the president on, please? He's busy? With who? Walter Gates? Watergate. Don't think I know him. Well, anyway, I'm having a little trouble with the railway again, and... Oh? Well, maybe Walter Cronkite won't be so busy. Hello there, Mr. President. How are you?
And get out of that army uniform before they send you overseas or something. Well, you know where to find me. Chock full of nuts, Denver, Colorado.
Goodbye. Let go, Standish. Let go. Let go! Let go!
You son of a bitch almost killed him.
That'll be fine, Mr. President. And while you're calling Amrail, I'll put in a call to High River and the mayor. And oh, you'll talk to him? Oh, that'll be fine. Thank you, Mr. President. And all my best to Mrs. Nickerson. And a pat on the head for Checkers.
You ready for this now?
Yeah, go ahead.
King of Spades.
King of Spades.
One, two, three.
You did look in the coffin, didn't you?
Yeah, but I couldn't tell you when Standish was here.
Didn't want to get her involved.
If that guy had killed me, he'd have killed her next. I'm good.
Good.
I never did thank you for saving my life, did I?
Oh, that's all right. We always have to stick together, you know.
Huh? Blackjack. Oh, how convenient.
Yes. So, you, open the coffin and...
There's about $1 million in there.
$5 million.
How do you know?
I counted it.
You mean to say there is $5 million? No.
Shh. What you got?
No wonder he's trying to kill me.
What you got?
Hit me.
Up, Doctor.
Tough luck, eh?
Yeah, tough luck.
Here, use that.
No, thank you. I have enough of my own.
Follows 7 aye, 2 no, 1 abstention, followed by the usual closing prayer delivered by Reverend. Meeting adjourned by Mayor Frizzoli. End of minutes.
I hear a motion to approve.
Mayor Frizzoli!
Oh, do that!
I'm sorry, sir, but this just arrived from the White House.
White House?
Yes.
What is it? Jesus. Herbert.
Charlie!
What's going on?
Daddy! His nephew, Lane Vilikov, has just died. His remains are being sent here to High River. The coffin arrives today on the Amrail Coast to Coaster.
Coast to Coaster doesn't come anywhere near here.
It does today, by special order of the President of the United States.
What?
So, they stole the money from Georgiana Latimer's father.
Right.
And Standish did see her in Ogden.
Probably.
I just don't get why Latimer would say there was only 100,000 missing when it was really 5 million.
Why would he put the money in the safe at home?
Because he was trying to hide it, that's why.
From who?
Well, who do we all try to hide our money from, dummy? The IRS.
Oh. What are we going to do?
Finders keepers, kid.
You mean you're going to steal it?
No. Latimer already stole it. You can't steal the same money from the government twice. That's double jeopardy.
Wait a minute. Robbery is robbery. You know
Shut up, Michael. You ungrateful asshole.
Standish, I just said goodbye to you. I almost got killed in the process.
Century just saved your life.
What are you doing?
We have to have something to put the money in.
Open again. Where the hell is he?
He's out back.
I told you to keep him in the house.
Well, he's helping me. I gotta do all the work myself, you know, since you made me fire everybody.
I had to fire everybody so they wouldn't know he was here.
Oh.
Hello, Uncle Mario.
Shut up.
All right, now listen to me, the two of you. There's a train arriving here in a couple of hours.
What train?
And on that train is Lane Biddlecoff's body.
But I'm Lane Biddlecoff.
Didn't I say shut up?
What are you talking about?
There's a stiff showing up here with your idiot son's name on it.
What?
That's right. He's no longer a living deserter. Now he's a dead hero.
There must be some mistake.
Of course it's a mistake. But the point is, we're the only ones who know it. Now look, when the stiff shows up, we do a bit at the railroad station. Half 5 minute parade, then zap, it goes in the ground. Zap, we cover it up. And we stick the moron here on the first banana boat for Venezuela.
How come I gotta go to Venezuela?
Because you didn't have the sense to get killed.
That is your nephew you're talking about, your own sister's son.
I don't want to go to Venezuela.
You should have thought of that when you deserted.
I wouldn't have deserted if you'd have kept me out of the draft.
What draft? You enlisted.
Oh, yeah. That's right.
Jesus, what a nitwit! Now look, you keep him in that house until I find a way to sneak him the hell out of this town!
You can go to the baggage car now. He's got them Dobermans tied up. I told him you wanted to unload that coffin in a few minutes.
Excuse me, are we coming into Omaha?
No, High River. You did say High River, didn't you?
Yeah.
That's what I told him on the phone.
What was that all about?
He thinks he talked to President Nixon, had the train rerouted to High River, Nebraska.
People, people, line up this instant. Along here, do you hear me?
Oh, kids. They wonder why I'm not married.
No, they don't.
Here comes the mayor. Oh,
wonderful.
Oh, my God. It's Wilt Chamberlain in drag.
They all set?
As we'll ever be.
You look lovely, Isadora.
All right, Zev, cut the crap. Let's get the show on the
mayor
road.
Mayor Frizzoli?
Yes?
Nadine Gardner, UBS affiliate, Omaha.
You covering this on television?
We certainly are. I was wondering, where is, Lane Biddlecoff's mother?
She won't be attending the funeral. She's overcome with grief.
I see.
He did it. We're in High River.
Two, three.
We're in some World War II movie.
Look, what's he playing?
Mad about the boy. What else?
I will do the talking.
Welcome to High River, Nebraska, on this sad but triumphant occasion. Words cannot begin to convey our feelings at this moment, so there won't be any. All right, get it out of there.
Excuse me. Excuse me, Your Honor. It is Your Honor, isn't it?
Yeah, Frizzoli, Mayor Frizzoli.
Allow us to introduce ourselves. This is Sergeant Rangeloff, a special graves detail. And I am the Reverend Bassinet, Walker Bassinet, Major, U.S. Army. Retired. I was Lane's chaplain.
This is the seventh. I am Isadora Frizzoli, and I have a lily and a poem for my cousin Lane.
She wrote it herself.
A lily for Lane Biddlecoff. I lay upon his coffin, and when he's underneath the ground, I'll come and see him often.
Okay, let's go.
Oh, one moment, please. In your moment of grief, I'm afraid you've overlooked someone. I am
Mrs. Lane Biddlehoff.
Cough.
We were married before he went overseas. Some of you may wonder why I'm not dressed in mourning. But if you were as close to Lane as I was, you would have known he would have wanted it just like this.
Play!
A march! 2-1-2!
Let's go, please, let's go!
Now, Coolidge had a dog. He was a farm boy, so he was partial to what you call your collie dog. Then there was Roosevelt, the one that was in the wheelchair. Now, he had a little black dog from Scotland by the name of Fallon.
It's funny Lane's mother never told us he got married.
Where is
his mother?
She's at home. She's prostrate with grief.
Prostrate?
Your Honor, I believe we're passing the funeral parlor.
That's right. Going right to the cemetery.
Hey, look out!
I wish you wouldn't keep doing that.
Hey, buddy, can you give me a lift? My car just broke down.
All right, that's it. Get the car. I'd like to thank you for bringing my nephew home to us. And, you know, if you're ever in the area, all that. When are you leaving?
Tomorrow morning.
Oh, you should try to stay in the Gateway Hotel tonight, because the other place in town is a rat hole.
Thank you, Mr. Frizzle.
Okay. I'll tell my sister you dropped by, Mrs. Biddlecoff.
Who's his sister?
Lane's mama, the prostate woman.
You had to be Lane's wife?
You guys took all the good parts.
Not funny, Standish.
$5 million divided by 6 feet.
Forget it.
That's $833,000 a foot. I can't forget it.
Anne-Marie! Anne-Marie.
What is it now?
Why did you tell me he was married?
He's not.
Don't give me that. His wife is here. She was at the funeral. Hi, Uncle Mario.
Why didn't you tell me you were married?
I'm not.
You lie to me. Your wife was at your funeral.
What's her name?
Well, how should I know? You tell me.
I could have been drunk or something. Maybe if I took a look at her. Where is she?
No. You stay right here. She's leaving tomorrow morning. You're leaving tomorrow afternoon. Count on it. All right. Okay, so let's set up. Once the sidewalks are rolled up tonight, Michael and I will dig up the money while Standish stays here and minds the store.
What if the phone rings?
This is Reverend Bassinet in the presidential suite. The widow Biddlecoff is resting. Would you please see that she is not disturbed and hold all calls, please? Thank you.
Okay, children. I'm off to filch a couple of shovels and stash them near the digs. Now, don't you fight while I'm away now.
How long will you be gone?
long enough.
Long enough for what?
Come on, Michael.
Really? Now? I'm too tense.
That's the point. Michael?
What do you mean Kissinger left for Paris? But Cronkite's supposed to interview him tonight. Don't apologize to me. Have Henry apologize to Walter when he gets back. Yeah, yeah, bye. Need a filler for tonight. Anything from the affiliates?
There's an offbeat human interest item from Omaha. Dead war hero, army buddy, grieving
yeah,
widow.
Yeah, whatever it is. A chop to 2 minutes will run it tonight.
Okay.
Michael?
Yeah?
I know you're an asshole and all. But I think I love you.
Well, I love you. And look at you. The mind of a maniac and the mouth of a longshoreman.
Do you? You really do?
Of course I do. Be quiet. I'm thinking.
What are you thinking?
About what's going to happen when that coffin doesn't arrive in New York.
How late?
At least a couple hours. It's been rerouted through High River, Nebraska. Say, you look familiar. Are you an actress? Handrail. I'll call you back.
What?
Bushed.
Gonna get me a cup of coffee. You coming in?
What are you stopping for? I can drive.
In a pig's ass. Nobody touches this wheel but Watsy Klinkowitz.
Who's he?
Welcome to High River, Nebraska, on this sad but triumphant occasion. Words cannot begin to convey our feelings at this moment, so there won't be any. All right, get it out of there.
Excuse me. Your Honor.
It is, Your Honor. Yeah, Frizzoli, Mayor Frizzoli.
Well, allow us to introduce ourselves. This is Sergeant Rangeloff, a special grave detail. And I am the Reverend Bessonet, Walker Bessonet, Major, U.S. Army.
Continuing our Night Owls news updates, we take you now to Nadine Gardner in High River, Nebraska.
Oh, my God. This is me. The performance of a lifetime. Nobody's going to see it. Should have called my agent now. No, don't need to. Why does this happen to me? Oh, my God, my teeth.
We were married before. Some of you may wonder why I'm not dressed in you.
What is it?
Lowers Mrs. Biddlehop.
Cough.
You would know. You would have watched.
Michael.
She was in here then?
Yes, she was.
Sitting over there?
Yes, sir.
Watching TV?
Yeah, she was watching TV, and then she suddenly got up and walked out the door.
What show?
The 10 o'clock news.
That door?
Yes, sir.
What's out there?
The street.
Good.
This is gonna take all night. What's that?
Nothing. Save your breath, kid. Dig. Come on.
Come on.
Move!
Nice place you got here.
Don't think it can go anywhere. This place is deserted.
You don't have to push.
We're just gonna sit and wait for your boyfriend to bring back my money. What are you doing? Come on. Just get inside. That's it, Grave Robber.
Good. Okay.
Let's fill the hole.
Damn. What's that?
I don't know, but they're coming this way. Let's get out of here.
Get up. Damn. Oh, Michael.
He's gone.
Hi, Isadora.
Cousin Lane! You've risen!
Huh?
Ah! He is risen!
Wait, is he? Wait, I gotta talk to your father.
Whoa.
Come on.
I knew it. I knew this would happen. Now you can retire, Sentry. You can retire. We can all retire.
Sing Sing, calm down. Nothing's happened yet.
It's gonna happen. It's gonna happen. Just get on the ladder.
Here.
Give me that.
Give me it. Ow! Grab it.
I've got it.
Okay.
Nothing
doesn't mean nothing. Nothing
will happen.
That's just what's...
Standish? Sergeant, see yourself on TV last night? You look just like you.
Listen, have you seen Standish and Mrs. Biddlehop cough?
No, I heard she was indisposed. Is there anything wrong?
No.
White House spokesman responding to questions about President Nixon's public blow-up at Press Secretary Ronald L.
Daddy! Daddy!
What?
He is risen!
What?
Cousin Lane has risen from the dead. I saw him.
My gosh, they're in a terrible mess.
Where?
In the cemetery. The box was empty, and there he
was.
What
box?
The coffin. He was out of it.
So are you, Isadora. Why don't you take one of your anti-crazy pills and leave your father alone, huh?
But it's true. Look. There he is.
Uncle Mario, well, I got something to tell you.
She's not here! She's not anywhere!
You better take the money and go. I'm calling the police.
If you want her back alive?
Oh, my God.
I already called him, and the address where he's holding you is on the other side.
Michael.
I want you to listen to me very carefully, okay?
I'm afraid I've made a terrible discovery. You see, the soldier that I came in here with is not a soldier at all, but he is an escaped convict.
How'd you find out?
Get the mayor on the telephone, quick.
I'd rather tell you, after you catch him, he's right in the next room.
Yeah, now listen. Just act normal. Do what you always do. You know, pray or something.
I'll be right over.
God bless you, my son.
Yeah, you're welcome. Did you get the mayor?
It's busy.
Well, keep trying. Better yet, I'd go to his house, bring him over to the Gateway Hotel.
Do you want me to hang up the phone?
You got the right address and everything?
Just fine.
This is fine.
Wait here.
You to keep him in the house, and you let him out!
Is it like on the other side?
Anne-Marie.
In Vietnam?
No, after death.
Anne-Marie.
What is it like?
I'm not dead.
Not now, maybe, but you were.
Anne-Marie.
God.
Of course I didn't tell Harriet she's got the biggest mouth in town. Now listen, Anne-Marie. All it takes is one ambitious young cop to find out I've been harboring a nephew who's a deserter from Vietnam, and they're coming here with handcuffs!
Right there, Your Honor. Phone down, hands up.
I'll call you right back.
Hi, Jeff. Long time no see.
How you doing, Lane? Should I put your hands up?
Oh, put that thing away. Look, you're making a very big mistake, Malone.
I'm making, Captain. That's what I'm making.
Excuse me, is this 65 and a half Legation Road?
Yes, it is.
This is 65 and a half Legation Road? This?
Yes, it is.
Well, where's the house?
It's gone. They moved it and it's gone down there.
I can't believe it. They took the house. The house is gone.
Where'd it go?
It's gone down the road.
Down the road which way?
Well, that way.
I don't believe it.
You don't believe it. I feel like Dorothy in the Wizard of Oz.
The house is gone. This is crazy.
Let's go down the road.
Both gone. Place has been turned upside down.
Did you find the widow Bidokoff? That Sarge was looking for her earlier.
He probably took care of her before he started on the Reverend. I gotta call the mayor. He should be here by now.
Can you help me? Is Sergeant Rangeloff registered here?
Yeah, he is, but he's out at the moment.
I'm looking for the sergeant myself.
I'll come back later.
Yeah, hold it right there, please. Who are you?
Mrs. Lane Biddlecoff.
Well, you're a bit late for the funeral, aren't you?
I missed my connection.
Too bad you wasted a trip.
Well, you've seen one funeral, you've seen them all.
Yeah, what I mean is that Widow Biddlecoff's here already.
I'm his second wife.
What's the connection between you and Sergeant Rangeloff?
He's got Lane's personal effects. And that bitch of a first wife's not going to get all of them if I've got anything to say about it. I'll see you guys later.
Not so fast, Miss Latimer. FBI, I'll take charge here.
Okay, you guys, put him up. Come on, up, up, up. You back, back. Come on, yeah, you. Yeah, come on, yeah. And you, come on. My hands off, pig.
All right, stop. You're under arrest. Just walk in front of me. Very slowly.
Thanks a lot.
I'll read your rights. You have the right to remain silent. Anything you say may be held against you. You have the right to make one telephone call.
Will you shut up?
You have the right to say that.
Where the hell's my car?
Looks like there's tracks up there. Okay, it's over there. It's down there. It's over there. Make the turn. Make the turn.
Take the... Whoa! Gonna tell you again. Find a place to turn this thing around.
Okay.
Now, right now.
All right. Just relax, okay?
Christ.
You're not gonna give him that money, are you?
I'm not gonna leave it in the car!
Jeez, I'm getting out of here.
Stuck this hair in my mouth to keep me from screaming.
Ormond, FBI. You're under arrest. Get him, Chief.
Okay, come on. You bastard!
Bye.
I'll get you! You bastard! You're not gonna get away with this!
Open the suitcase, Michael. I want to wave the money at him.
What's this?
I think the yellow's the classified.
Where's the money? He switched the bags. You son of a bitch!
Come on, Michael, you're starting to sound like me.
Get him in the camp.
When did he do it? Yeah. How?
What does it matter? We're alive. We've got each other. Come on, forget about the money, Michael.
I suppose you need a little. You made the switch. Got to have a place to live. And a car.
You had it all the time.
Two cars.
You could have had me killed for two phone
books. And the Bible.
We all could have been killed.
Shh, Michael, I'm counting.
You know something?
Save some for yourself.
Not to worry.
Did you write the book of love?
This side is mine.
The Bible tells you so. And do you believe in rock and roll? Can music save your mortal soul? And can you teach me how to dance real slow? Well, I know that you're in love with him, 'cause I saw you dancing in the gym. You both kicked off your shoes. Man, I dig those rhythm and blues. I was a lonely teenage bronc and buck with a pink carnation and a pickup truck. But I knew I was out of luck. Knew the day the music died, I started singing bye bye Miss American Pie. Drove my Chevy to the levee, but the levee was dry. Them good old boys were drinking whiskey and rye and singing, this'll be the day that I die, die. Now for 10 years we've been on our own, and moss grows fat on a rolling stone. But that's not how it used to be. When the jester sang for the king and queen in a coat he borrowed from James Dean, and a voice that came from you and me. Oh, and while the king was looking down, the jester stole his thorny crown. The courtroom was adjourned.